On this Earth Day, raising awareness about food waste. In the United States, 30 to 40% of food produced is never consumed by humans. And more than 90% of that waste ends up in a landfill. Emily Noonan went out to find what is being done locally to help solve this problem.
Food waste is a problem. The Rochester Institute of Technology is taking action.
On one hand, we're wasting all this food, but then on the other hand, a significant fraction of the American population doesn't have enough food to eat.
So Tom Trabold from the Department of Sustainability wanted to figure out how to take food from being wasted and give it to people who need it. He found a solution.
We take food waste and break it down in the absence of oxygen to produce biogas, which then can be used similar to natural gas to produce electricity, to heat buildings, or even cleaned up as a transportation fuel.
RIT Dyeing Services now donates 15,000 pounds and composites more than 200 tons of waste a year.
What many people don't realize is a lot of the food waste happens right here in your own fridge. We buy food in bulk, it goes bad, we throw it away. Here's another option.
You can dehydrate those materials and convert them into food powders or food supplements that kind of extend the life of those products and also add value and economic value to the food waste producer.
Wegmans will take its slightly bruised items and work them into a recipe or donate them to a food bank.
They have some kind of opportunity to send to a farm, either to a digester, to a composting operation, or, you know, just animal pigs and cows like to eat produce too.
And with landfills rapidly growing every day, action must be taken sooner than later. Emily Noonan, News 8.
RIT hopes to get a larger composter and an anaerobic digestive system on campus sometime in the future to help with that.